So, fierce debate on social media. Some people arguing that Rebecca Vardy is using her pregnancy to gain sympathy or as some sort of excuse.
Is that the case? We're here to discuss that. Is her very close friend Nicola McLean, and our resident agony aunt Vanessa Felt. So you are very close friends with her. You've been in touch. How is she?
Yeah, I've not spoken to her today, but you can imagine how she is. Absolutely. You're devastated.
Yeah. The timing of this, I mean, you know, I must admit I have a lot of sympathy with the fact that if you're heavily pregnant, and you both have been in your time, 7 months into all of this, it doesn't take much to upset the whole balance that's going on.
Absolutely. I mean, forget who it is, whether it's, you know, a celebrity, a wag, or, a normal person. Pregnancy, we all know stress can cause so much upset. You know, it can cause... We've just had a report from psychiatrists not that long ago that says it can affect the baby's brain. I mean, you shouldn't be this stressed out when you're pregnant.
What kind of trolling has she been getting that she told you about?
Oh, it's... Well, I know I've been reading it personally. It's horrific. You know, hope the unborn baby dies. Hope they both die. It's been... This level of abuse is horrific, especially if you're pregnant.
Would she not just come off social media? Because that is hideous. There's no excusing that kind of behaviour. But would it not just be easier to come off social media and not look at it?
She's not sitting here. You know, would you come off social media? I don't know. It's one of those forbidden fruits, isn't it? You want to see what people are saying. But the point is, we know the damage of social media. It's been heightened. I used to argue back with people. I used to say my opinion on social media. I've not done that for years. The reason is, when it first started, we used to just say things and think it was fine. We know it's not. We've had two reality stars committing suicide. We've got a pregnant woman here. No matter who it is, that should not be subjected to this level of abuse. And Colleen Rooney doing it when she's a mother, she should know that this is not acceptable. Come out now and say, you know, until Rebecca is proven guilty, let's leave this now. This is not okay.
Were you surprised, Vanessa, that she did do it so publicly? Because even if she had, she believes it to be true. Were there ways she could have done this? Because she has opened the floodgates by doing it so publicly for that kind of trolling.
I mean, am I surprised? Yes, that's why it's a news story, because you don't normally get high-profile people saying how they really feel quite so publicly, and you don't normally see revenge, vengeance, you know, all this kind of thing, and that's why it's a hypnotically attractive story and people can't get enough of it. I mean, broadsheet papers, the tabloid papers, and people in, you know, in the supermarket saying to each other, what do you think? You think she did it? You think she didn't do it? Is there really any doubt that she did it? It's fascinating, because they're so high profile. But I think you can see why Colleen Rooney didn't want to do this privately. If she just phoned her and said, mate, I know it's you. It's you, because you're the only person who's got access to this.
But she's seven months pregnant.
And she didn't say, it's you. She said, it's Rebecca's account.
She would have had forensic lawyers checking what she could and couldn't say. That's why she had to say it's her account rather than it's you, isn't
it? I disagree with you. I don't think she knows that it's Rebecca. And I think, exactly, she's 7 months pregnant. And I think it's really hypocritical that any show sits there and talks so much about mental health and mental well-being, but it's all right to slam, you know, a person because she's not as likable as the other person or she's not as famous as the other person.
So you think this could have waited more weeks?
This could have waited. Apparently, it's been going on for how many... But Colleen said it's been going on for how many years? Let it wait. Be respectful. As I say, we are so much more far forward in mental health now than we've ever been. And this is OK to just do now because it's a person that people...
But then, Nicola, we're not slamming her. Vanessa's saying, you know, this is a show that we talk about what's in the newspaper.
I'm not slamming anybody.
Yeah. We're just saying this is what people are talking about.
If it was really her or if somebody hacked into her account, nobody really knows.
We're talking about a pregnant woman, so regardless. And you know what? So it's Colleen's basement got flooded or something's going to happen to a pregnant woman and a baby.
Let's get really real about this. You know, pregnancy is not an illness. Now, if somebody says she's got to carry something heavy up a very high ladder, the answer is, of course not. She's heavily pregnant.
But
when pregnant, you can't insulate yourself against all stress. I've got two daughters. Both of them worked till the very, very last minute of the pregnancy so that they could have the longest holiday with the baby, you know, longest pregnancy leave. So they're negotiating the commute, you know, on the tube, on a crowded...
They're not dealing with
full days. This is a lady who's on holiday. This is her fifth baby, not her first.
That makes no difference. Hold on a minute. That makes no difference. And if Dr. Raj was here now, he would be saying exactly the same thing as me. You have to protect yourself in pregnancy, regardless if it's your fifth. So it's your fifth. Oh, it doesn't matter then if this fifth baby gets put under this horrendous strain and death threats and this and that, because it's my fifth baby. Like, I'm not saying that you have to mollycoddle someone. I would rather carry something up a flight of stairs than I would have death threats and have this level of stress.
The death threats are not going to ruin his fault. Do you know, Colleen?
Well, she could have stopped it. Well, she could have stopped it. She didn't need to do this. I don't know Colleen, and I'm not saying that Colleen's a bad person. I don't know her. But I'm saying, as a mother and as someone that's been in this industry now for a long time, and we are aware what happens when we post something. You are aware, with her level of following, if you post this, this is what's going to happen. She knew that, and she chose to put a pregnant woman under this much stress. I'm sorry, regardless, I can't see an argument against...
If she had done it in a couple of months' time, would you find it less awful?
Yes.
Right, so you think she should have just waited
yes.
for the birth?
I think she should have waited to
said,
find out.
I've just given birth, I'm breastfeeding, or I've got a toddler, or I've got five children. I mean, there's always never going to be a good time to be exposed in this way. Never. And she's never going to be thrilled about it, is she?
If someone caused your daughter this level of stress, whether we don't know who's right and wrong...
I'd be devastated, obviously.
Exactly. Obviously. So all I'm saying, we all have to have compassion about the fact that we are talking about, regardless of how many pregnancies she's had. I've had two pregnancies. My second wasn't any easier than my first. You know, regardless of how many pregnancies, we've got someone who's 7 months pregnant, receiving death threats and saying that they hope her unborn baby dies.
Which is this awful. Is I mean, nobody can condone that. We as a programme obviously don't condone that. But she, Rebecca Vardy, is always in the press. You know, she uses the press. So that's why I'm saying, why don't you just come off social media? The press, obviously, it was going to be in the front of the papers. You can't get round that. But you can come off and stop reading
death threats, hand it to the police. Let her come off social media. That's fine. I agree. You know, there's been times when I've had to come off social media. I've never been front page of every magazine. I've not had newspapers. I've never had people camping outside my house, going to family's house. You know, I've never had this level of intrusion. Regardless of if she comes off, she is aware of the level of hatred against her. In the newspapers, you've got Colleen Rooney stand there in, you know, a fluffy jumper and jeans. And you've got Rebecca Vardy with a snake wrapped around her in underwear. You know, the press know what they're doing. Yes. She's 7 months pregnant.
I'm going to ask you both, do you think Rebecca Vardy can come back from this? Do you think that she will ever be forgiven for this?
I would be surprised, because I think most people think that she's been banged to rights. I mean, they may, you know, there may be an argument about someone's hacked into the account or somebody else, but who? How many people? And in
well,
what circumstances?
Well, PR companies, management companies, people that have the passwords.
Yes, possibly, but I think, you know, she's had quite a lot of bad press anyway. She's somebody who does rub people up the wrong way. I don't know whether she means to and she enjoys it or she doesn't mean to, but she certainly excels at doing that. And if you watched her in the jungle, you will see she seemed pretty ruthless. She seemed very focused and very, I suppose, to some extent, self-centred. And there's something about her that you know, people find, you know, kind of really does get on their nerves. So
that's so where she's the already, bullying aspect
she's already
comes
starting because, on the back foot, as it were,
because
isn't
people
she, really?
Don't like her as much as they like Colleen. That just proves my point, isn't it? It's OK that this is happening because Rebecca Vardy rubs people up the wrong way. I mean, I'm not looking at this biasly. I watched Rebecca in the Jungle and I thought she was brilliant. I thought she was so fierce, so great. But that's like me, isn't it? If you're an outspoken, strong female, people aren't going to like you. I like her.
You think
her.
That's the problem? She's got that that image.
Do you think there's other things that Colleen Rooney should be outspoken about?
Well, you know, not for me to say, because I don't like it when people speak about my personal life and my relationship, hence why I don't do it and I don't out people anymore. Did I used to argue on Twitter? Absolutely. But do I know now that if, you know, I don't want to hurt people's feelings, and I also don't want it done back to me because I'm not strong enough to deal with it. So if Colleen wants to be this outspoken, then maybe she needs to be out in other people in her life as well.
I don't see why, really. Why should she?
Why should she out Rebecca?
Well, why shouldn't she? I mean, I think if you feel that you've been targeted, betrayed, somebody who pretends to be your friend and is supposed to be close to you, and you know that they're peddling your secrets,
they
that's very
close.
Guys,
they
gotta leave it
close.
There. Thank you. Thank you both very much indeed, Vanessa and Nicola.
Well, I think it is one of those, a story that will rumble on, won't it? So I'm sure we'll be talking about it again. Thank you both very much.